first part of the subset question asks about planar graphs and trees. First thing to note is that not all planar graphs are trees. For example, here is a ring, which is a planar graph, and it's not a tree. And so planar graphs are not a subset of trees. On the other hand, all trees are planar graphs. For most trees, it's fairly intuitive to see how it could be drawn in the plane. For example, this one is already planar. But for other trees, it might not be so obvious that we can rearrange everything to lay it flat in a plane. And so it'd be nice to have a proof that all trees are planar instead of relying just on intuition. One way to prove this is to show that any tree can be drawn inside of a triangle, and then larger trees can be constructed by combining these triangles. More formally, what we want to show is that any tree can be drawn in a plane inside a triangle with any given node at the apex of the triangle. And so, for the base case of one node, we can draw the node at the apex of the triangle, and this is trivially in a plane. And so, for our inductive step, we assume that the claim is true for all graphs with less than n nodes, and we want to show that the claim is true for all graphs with n nodes. So we'll start with a tree with n nodes. We'll use this for example. We're going to pick any node kind of at random. We'll call it R. For example, we'll have this node be R. And then we remove R. Because our original graph was a tree, this separates the graph into separate disjoint trees. And now, since each of these trees have less than n nodes, we can draw each one inside of a triangle. First, we can take this tree of four nodes and draw it inside of a triangle. Notice that the node that was connected to R is at the apex of the triangle. And then we can do the same for the other two trees. And then in our last step, we make a bigger triangle and we put R at the apex and then connect it to the apexes of the other triangles. So this verifies our claim and shows that all tree graphs are planar.
They're definitely neither due to the definition of trees. A tree can have no cycles and a ring must have a cycle.
So the answer is neither.
Right.
Cool.
Never got a really specific definition of a chain besides just the example, which was enough, but...
Same idea. Kind of a chain doesn't have a cycle, whereas a ring does.
The other thing we got definitely was that the edges in a chain is the number of nodes minus one, and the edges in a ring is equal to the nodes. Therefore, there can be no crossover between them. They're mutually exclusive. All chains are trees, but not all trees are chains, so it's the first one. It satisfies the definition of a tree graph that it's connected, but there's no cycles. And then the other description of a tree graph, that every pair of nodes in the graph has a unique path between them. I mean, a chain does that also. This is definitely one that answers intuitively just by looking at examples.
Mm-hmm.
Gives me 100% confidence in making that claim.
Yeah. And just kind of a quick example of that's a tree that is not a chain. So.
Right. And they're neither. And the way I convinced myself of that is drawing an example of a hypercube that was not a ring and a ring that was not a hypercube. So long as you have a ring that's anything but four nodes, it's not a hypercube.
Okay.
And any hypercube that's anything but four nodes is definitely not a ring.
Very true. So, yeah, I'll draw one for you. Yeah, and just the normal cube.
All right.
And our second to last problem is just grids and chains.
All chains are grids, but not all grids are chains. So it's the chains are a subset of grids.
Yeah.
I mean, any chain of with n nodes is a 1/n grid. Once you get a grid that has more than one in either of the two directions, it's no longer a chain. And no matter how long you make a chain.
Yep. So this is.
You can add a node to a chain, a node in it to a chain, that makes it not a grid.
Kind of the first thing you said, we have a 1/n grid and it's also a chain. But, yeah. Yeah, this is. for example, not a chain.
Correct.
Cool.